Welcome to Abracadabra TV.
The magic is here.
Ladies, it is wonderful to be here with you, wherever you may be in the world. It is a great thing to convene virtually in this way. With AbraFest, I'm thrilled to be here. My name is Chris Keener, and I'm a breathwork guide. So I wonder if you've ever done breathwork before. If not, I'm thrilled to introduce you to it. It's your breath. You know it well. You are familiar with it. But let's see just how powerful your breath can be in this next hour. I encourage you to give this a shot. Breathwork is one of those things, you can talk about it, you can think about it, but that's not particularly helpful. This is a doing. We do the breathwork, and then we feel the results of the breathwork, and that's pretty much all there is to say about it. I'm gonna say a few things before we get going, but let's actually get going. So bring your hands to your, right below your rib cage here. This is called your diaphragm. Meet your diaphragm. It's a wonderful muscle that keeps you breathing. And we are going to breathe into it now, filling up through the nose. So feel your diaphragm expand, feel your belly expand as you take a nice slow breath in through your nose. And then let it go. Feel that expansion for two. And let it go again. Keep that moving. Big, deep inhale. Three, exhale, let go. Bigger, deeper, four, fill up. And letting go, exhaling. Fill up for five. We're gonna do 11 of these. Exhale, let go. This is called an 11-11 breath. Fill up and let go. Keep it moving. Great breath for a quick state change. Exhale to get you out of a funk. Inhale to get you into a good flow state, a good spot, ready for action, ready for anything. Exhaling, three more. Here we go. Fill up, let go. Two more, fill up, and release. Last one, filling up, fill up, and then hold your breath for 11. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and slowly letting go, relaxing on the exhale. You might close your eyes for a moment and just check in. How do you feel? Good. However you feel, that's just right. No way you're supposed to feel here. It's just your breath. It's a quick reset. I love that 11-11 breath before any big meeting or acceptance speech. It's a wonderful thing to do. What we're headed for is what I call a golden air breathwork session. It's really an aggregation of methodologies that go back thousands of years, but in a particular sequence that allows us to access a non-ordinary state of consciousness. That's right. Our brain's gonna feel some change in this. We're actually gonna go through a lot of intensity in this practice. And so it is not recommended if you have anything that would keep you from a vigorous workout. If you are pregnant, you probably want to skip this. If you have any histories of psychiatric disorders, also probably want to skip this, as it is intense. If you're clear for takeoff, just know that some sensations are likely to come during this breath work. So for the mind, body, and spirit. For the mind, it is challenging. We're doing something different. We're breathing in a new pattern. Our brain will recognize this as new information, and there may be some resistance here. It may be challenging. So just know that. It's like a workout. The more you do it, the more you'll get used to it. And by the end, you'll be coasting. For the body, some sensations are likely to come that include but are not limited to feelings of lightness, heaviness. You may feel hot, you may feel cold, you may get tingly in your body, or you may feel some version of this, a tensing, a clenching of the hands, feet, wrists. This is called tetany. This happens to you, you're amongst friends. It happens to many people in breathwork, about half of us. And just know that it is not dangerous. As you resume breathing normally at the end of this practice, it will all dissipate. If at any time in the breath work it just becomes too uncomfortable, you can slowly breathe through your nose and all those sensations go away. But just know that if your hands do this, you're not stuck like this, it's not permanent. Remember my voice now telling you this, that it is not permanent and it's not dangerous. Lastly, for the spirit, for our emotional body, this breath work we do is something of an inner cleansing. I mean, we walk around with a lot of anxiety about the future, a lot of depression from our past. And this is something that puts us right in that present moment. We are with our breath during this. And because of that, we're processing a lot of stuff. So emotion tends to come. Laughter tends to come. Tears tend to come. Whatever comes for you, just let it come. Let it out. This is a great place to do it. It's a great time to do it. These are strange times, so we must travel lightly on this road. So I encourage you, just if you want to make a sound, make a sound. You want to move your body, move your body. So we have a gas pedal and brakes during this breath work. The gas pedal is this breath I'm about to show you. The brakes, always slow breathing through the nose. Again, if at any time you want to slow it down, breathe through the nose, you have access to that. Here's the gas pedal. Put one hand on your belly, one hand on your chest. We're gonna do this all through the mouth. So first we're gonna fill up the belly and then fill up the chest and then exhale, letting go all through the mouth. So fill up your belly, fill up your chest and exhale, let go. Continuous breath, come right back to the belly, to the chest and let it go. That's it, that's called a three-stage breath. We're going to be doing that for about 25 minutes before we transition into a series of breath retentions or breath holds. Everybody take a big deep breath in, slowly let it go, and hold empty. I'm going to hold empty like that. I'll take a big deep breath in, hold full. We're going to hold full like that, and then exhale, letting go. By the time we get to those breath holds, you're going to be able to hold your breath for quite some time as you have very little CO2, plenty of oxygen. So just know that if you want to hold longer than IQ, you can, you may, you must. If you want to at any time breathe in, do that. It's not a contest. Lastly, we'll do a guided visualization meditation, and then we will float off into the world and into the rest of this amazing festival, lighter people, we would hope. So let's go ahead and do the thing. Let's lie down. Find your space. You want to be lying down on your back for this practice. Great to have a blanket nearby in case you get chilly. Great to wet your whistle just so your mouth is not too dry. And lastly, if you want to have a pillow handy, it might help. Not so much to put under your head. We're actually going to have our head flat on the floor. But a pillow can be helpful if you want to make some noise into it. You want to scream, you want to yell, you want to holler. That would be great. So find your place now, go ahead and lie down. You can close your eyes. The first thing we're gonna do is just begin a calming breath in and out through the nose. Before we begin the work, we have to decide to be here. That's our first and most important decision here with breath work. It's just simply to show up for it. To decide to do this, to give this our intention, our energy, our time. This is an investment in yourself. So close your eyes and begin to drift inward, inviting these calming waves of breath in through the nose and out through the nose or mouth. Just beginning to listen to your breath. In this process of breath work, we're going to hand over the reins to our body. We're going to allow our body to really speak, to take control. So we can begin to surrender now, slightly surrendering to your next breath. And And we do so by finding any pockets of tension in your body, anywhere you feel resistance, jitters. Just bring some breath there, calm it down, release it into the floor. Gravity take over. Rising and falling of breath. It comes all the way down to your feet, your legs, relaxing there. Breath into your pelvis, your sex, your creative center. Relaxing there. Breath to relax the hands and arms and shoulders. And a breath as your head falls back, throat clears. Allowing your face to flee of any expression, nothing to say, nothing to express. All is listening. I'm just going to welcome in whatever this journey brings. So let's do that by beginning with a big inhale through the mouth. So now filling up through your mouth, big deep inhale, and letting go. Two more like that, big deep inhale to transition, bringing some work to this, fill up. And then exhale, let it go. And final big deep inhale. Deep, deep inhale, and we're going to sigh it out. Make a sound. Good, and with that, we are ready to begin a three-part breath and the work part of this breath work. So bring one hand to your belly and one hand to your chest. We're going to do this with eyes closed, again, lying on our back. And so go ahead and take a big, deep breath in to fill up your belly. And then one to fill up your chest. And then exhale, letting go. Again, fill up your belly, fill up your chest, and exhale, letting go. Again, belly, fill up your chest, exhale, let go. Feel your bottom hand rise, your top hand rise, and then exhale, both hands fall back towards your spine, and we begin again, belly, chest, exhale, letting go. So fill up, and let go. Come right back again. Belly, chest, exhale, all through the mouth. Keep that going. There's a beat here to breathe to. If you like to, stick with that. You may choose to speed your breath at any time or slow your breath. There is no wrong way to do this. There's no wrong way to breathe. So just be with your breath. Committing with every single breath to just showing up, to just giving yourself over to this process, whatever might come. Whatever might be headed your way, we cannot know. The only way to know is through this breath, belly, chest, exhale. Keep it going. This is our job for the next 22 minutes, our soul devotion to do this belly, chest, exhale, all through the mouth. If you're just joining us, we're lying down on our back, filling up the belly, filling up the chest, and relaxing, letting go. As the air falls out without effort. There's no effort in this exhale. It is a surrender, it is a letting go. So what we have here is two welcomes to welcome in the breath. And one exhale, one expiration, one goodbye to let it go. And then we come right back again, fill up, let go, fill up. fill up, let go, and keep it going. Continuing to breathe your breath. This may be challenging already. It's quite likely to face some resistance early in this breathwork practice because it is a new breath. It's something different that we're doing. It's challenging. So just know that you're supported not only by your body, which has always supported you, your breath that has always been there for you. Since the very moment of your birth, this breath has supported you. But also supported by people all over the world breathing together in concert. All breathing together. We got you. So stick with this. Knowing that if at any time you need to slow the breath, you're going to breathe through your nose, you have full access to that. So if at any time this gets too challenging and you want to get off the ride, just slowly breathe through your nose. All the sensations will go away. That said, maybe this is your day to go for it. Maybe this is your day to release some of that old stuff that doesn't serve you anymore. Try something different to open up to new possibility. And the way we do that is with an open mouth, breathing in to the belly, and then filling up the chest, and then exhaling, letting go. Coming right back again. A recommitment. Every breath a new chance to recommit to this process. And a chance to drop into the present moment. You have never breathed the breath past. You never breathe the future breath. You're always breathing this one now. So this very act of breathing is how we get present, is how we find the present moment. We find it in this breath here. And then in this breath here. And this one. Continuing forward, yes. Continuing to head towards unknown places. You may be starting to feel a lot of tingliness in your body, a lot of energy, electricity running through you. Know that that's all part of this. You are safe and held by this incredible body, this incredible breathing apparatus that you have. So just know that. Maybe you welcome these sensations. It's a sign that it's working. Often when we feel resistance, it comes in the process of transformation. It comes as we begin to change, begin to take on new, exciting frontiers of life. Always come with this challenge. Are you willing to do the work? Are you going to show up for yourself? We can do that gently. We can do that with compassion. We can do that with a spirit of affirmation. Saying yes to what your body wants. Does your body want to breathe? Say yes to it. Fill up. Fill up. Let go. Body want to get rid of old baggage? Say yes to it. Welcome in what's coming forth. It's beginning to bloom. Good. On your next exhale, let's let out a sigh. Let's make a sound. Go ahead, make a sound. Even if you sound ridiculous, that would be great. Feels good to let that sound go. That inner vibration may free up some things for you. This is a freeing practice. You are free here. Come back to your breath. Belly, chest, exhale. If you're just joining us, or if you haven't started breathing with us yet, what are you waiting for? This is not an observational sport. This is no spectating. This is an active process of self-investigation, of healing, transformation even. In fact, we're always transforming. We are always changing. You are never the person you once were. So if you don't like what's here for you now, if this is too difficult, what happens if you keep breathing? Something else is headed your way. Guaranteed. It always is. Such is life. Maybe we'll pick it up a little bit. Belly, chest, exhale. Belly, chest, exhale. As though marching forward in the breath, giving yourself to this breath more with each one. This is often the time where we meet perhaps the most resistance, because we're about to lift off. So this is where you can really decide to surrender to your body, to surrender to this breath, to find the more effortless qualities of the exhale. As the exhale just falls out of your mouth. No need to force that exhale. It is a small death, it is a letting go. It's the leaves falling from the trees in autumn. To fertilize the new soil, the new growth. So we let that go, let it all go. Whatever you want to let go, let it go. Keep breathing, stay with you. Belly, chest, exhale. And if you're still wondering, am I doing this right? You are doing it right. There's no wrong way to do this. Just stay with you. If you're wondering, am I safe? Ask your body, ask your breath, am I safe? Is this not the same breath that has always kept you safe, that has always supported your very life, your very livelihood? You can literally trust this with your life. Whatever you may be feeling in your body now, permission to feel it, encouragement to let it develop, let it grow. If it's frustration, feel frustration. If it's curiosity, get curious. If it's fear, get curious. And curiosity is the antidote to fear. What is this? Where am I headed? What can I relinquish? What can I let go? Where am I always holding on tight? Where am I always trying to control? And what if I didn't always have to have control? What if in some ways control were just an illusion anyway? What if I could let go, let go, let go, let go? Just give yourself to the breath. Here we go. Belly, chest, exhale. If you're just joining us, we're doing this on our backs, lying down, eyes closed, filling up the belly, then the chest, then exhaling all through the mouth. Fill up the belly, chest, exhale. Coming right back and doing it again without pause, a circular breath, an active breath, a working breath. That work is praise. It's the way that we devote ourselves to the act of living by showing up, by putting forth some effort. And then alternately, by just surrendering, letting go. Two welcoming inhales, and exhale, say goodbye. In just a few moments here, we're going to do our first breath hold. So preparing for that, belly, chest, exhale, keep it going. We're going to do a few more breaths. And then we're going to exhale all of our air and hold on the exhale. Preparing for that, two more rounds, belly, chest, exhale. On your next exhale, exhaling all of your air and then holding empty, holding still. So no air in the lungs, no air in the belly. You have oxygen everywhere, you are supported in this place known as your middle breath, the place between breaths. Expansive place. You're welcome here anytime. We'll come back here later in the journey, but for now we're going to come back to a belly chest exhale. A big deep inhale to fill up your belly, fill up your chest, exhale, let go. And again, belly, chest, exhale. Forwards on this journey, deep into this journey. You're doing amazing. Keep doing, more than halfway there. Stick with this, stick with your breath. You may find that the tethers holding you down begin to unfurl, unravel. As you begin to lift off the ground, your boat begins to set sail in open seas. Can begin to find expansiveness here. And if part of this feels unknown, unprecedented, wonderful, wouldn't that mean we are doing something we've never done before? Wouldn't that mean we're headed for somewhere we've never been? Wouldn't that be great? Belly, chest, exhale. Stay with you. Be with your breath. whatever pace you're breathing, stick with it. You breathe in 5% more air, do so. If it's your time to slow your breath, the sensations are being a bit overwhelming, you can slow your breath, breathe through your nose. Just continue to be here in this experience, fully in this experience. There is nowhere else to be. There's no other time to do this. There's no other time to take care of you. There's no other time to be free, to be full, to be untethered, to be open, to continue. Now probably feeling a lot of electricity in your body, maybe your hands, feet, feeling this, in this. Is there any doubt that you are alive right now, that your body is swimming? The very stuff of life, they call it prana, they call it chi. Call it rua. There's a word in every language for this remarkable force of life that you bring in, that you move through, and move forward in the breath. Fill up, let go, keep going, keep breathing. Support it. Breathing through these transitions, you're almost there. Just a few more minutes of this three-stage breath before we transition, so be with you here. Fill up, let go. Let's make another sound, let something go. Let's make a laugh. Let's make a laugh come forth. You can force it if you have to. Can't imagine where a laugh would come from. Let it bloom. Ha 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 ha. It is a crazy thing to be doing this breath work. It is crazy to feel this way. It is wild and wonderful. And so we bring some levity to it here. Belly, chest, exhale. Keep going, keep breathing. Feeling whatever you gotta feel. There's emotion here, we let it come. If there's movement, we let it come. We just get out of the way where our body begins to speak, begins to heal, begins to shout from the mountaintops that it wants to be alive, to thrive. Feel that thriving. remarkable time to be walking this planet, to be in this body, to be embodied. Remarkable thing to be taking trillions of particles from the air and bringing them into this soft membrane of body and converting them to billions of transactions, into parcels of energy, packets of vitality, spectacular explosions of life in the vein that animate you, that bring you the life that you are living. This incredible gift of living. And who are you living for? Who are you breathing for? And we're gonna make a sound here. We're gonna make it loud. If you wanna let it be loud, you can bring a pillow to your mouth. But let a sound go in three. We're gonna let something go in two. Make a sound, make your sound, and one, if you want to scream, you want to yell, let it go, let it go, let it go now. Let it all go. Back to your breath. All of this in the body, this energy, this sensation, whatever you may be feeling, bringing it with you. As we transition the pattern of breath to one breath in, one breath out, stay with this, stay with the work, filling up and letting go, and in and out. Keep that going. Inhale, exhale, a natural pattern of breath, filling up and letting go. We're headed for breath hold, breath retention. We're just inviting in as much oxygen as we like in this transition. Exhaling, releasing, surrendering any tension still in the body, any resistance at all, anything at all you'd like to let go of comes out on this next exhale, these next few exhales. As we head towards that middle breath, that breath hold, keep going. 10 more breaths. Five more. Slowing it down. Three more. Two more. Big deep inhale. Letting go. And a final deep breath in. Slowly letting go. Letting it all go and holding empty. Holding empty. Holding still. So holding the breath here, no air in the lungs, no air in the belly, oxygen everywhere, vitality everywhere. Knowing that if at any time you need to breathe in, I'm just going to do so. See if you can stick with this just a few more moments, and we'll take a big deep breath in and we'll hold at the top of the breath. You're joining me now, big deep inhale, holding full, being present to whatever here, whatever sensation here. And then exhaling, letting go. We'll do one more round, just like this. back to fill up. And let go. And in and out. Headed for one more series of breath retention, breath holds. So for now, big deep inhales, exhales to let go. This is the last of the work that we'll do here today. So showing up for this work, whatever way feels right to you. Maybe these big deep inhales, maybe really want to see what's possible here. You know we're headed for that quiet place, so working our way there, these last 15 breaths. Five more, slowing it down, bigger, deeper. And three more breaths, huge breaths in, slowing it down, last two. Exhaling and a final inhale, fill up, slowly, slowly exhaling. Exhaling all the breath and holding empty, holding still, holding still. Finding your middle breath, this place of quiet. This is your horizon. And you are most welcome here. Again, here as long as it feels good, not a moment longer. When you do get the urge to breathe in, I'm going to take a final big deep breath in and hold at the top one last time. If you'd like to, continuing to hold or joining me in that big deep breath in to hold full. And when you next exhale, it's to full surrender, to full rest. Letting a natural breath take over. Work of the breath work complete. Well done. Well done. Just allowing that natural breath to come and go through the nose. With eyes closed and body fully relaxed. And joining me, if you like, in an imagination. Picturing yourself in a wide open space. There's a hill that rises from the valley. And atop this hill, a grand crystal castle beams of light echoing from the translucent walls. You're drawn into this place, this incredible structure rising all around you, this great hall within. And sensing that you belong here, this is your castle, your kingdom on the hill. This is the kingdom, this is the queendom of your life. And in this sacred place, this lofted, incredible place, is where you keep those things in your life that are most important to you. Memories. Experiences. So you might picture a time in your life where you felt a sense of achievement, where you did something that you were proud of. Battle hard won through effort. Whatever comes, picture this time and see it here in this hall as though projected before you, this memory. Or you accomplished something. And who is here with you? How did it feel? See that moment all over again. Be there all over again. In this vaulted crystal room. This treasured experience. Feel that in your heart. And then you might see the scene begin to change to one of laughter, to a time in your life where you laughed heartily. Maybe doubled over with friends. Who was there? What were you laughing at? Picture it now. These fits of laughter. It's good to laugh. And you might bring your hand to your heart and feel, as you bring hand to heart, you feel that laughter in your heart. Feel how good that feels. And the scene may change again. This time, a scene of heartbreak, sadness. A time where life was tough, where you were going through it. And how did you make it through? Feel your resourcefulness. Feel whatever you may feel here. Feel it in that heart, under your hand. And know that this crystal place, this kingdom on a hill, is where you came to heal, is where you come to move on. To renew. And so you may sense the scene change again. It's time to a scene from your life where you felt loved. You felt utterly supported and held. Where you looked out and there was someone's gazing back at you with acceptance, with admiration. An unbounded appreciation and love, and feel that in your heart, and feel their gaze, and see their kind eyes now looking at the miraculous creature that is you. And in this space, with your hand on this heart, you see reflected in every surface around you a vision of yourself. And it is beautiful. It is capable. It is impressive. It is golden. And acknowledge this heart beating in this chest, for it is yours. And how wonderful. Light breeze might blow across this hilltop, through the walls of this castle, begin to bring us back. So you might bring some light movement back to your fingers. Gentle rolling of your wrists. Toes wiggle, ankles fall side to side. And you let your head rock back and forth. Begin a journey back to seated position, taking your time, and doing your best to keep your eyes closed, to move with integrity. And as you come back to seated position, bringing with you all the gifts and challenges of this breathwork practice, what did you see? What did you feel? Knowing that that information came from a valuable place, the most valuable place within you. What would you remember? What would you take forward? What would you integrate? We'll come to close this practice by bringing our hands up overhead and bringing your hands to fists. Gesture honoring the work of breathwork. This is a difficult practice. It is different each time we do it. Each time we come back to it, it brings different gifts, different challenges. So acknowledging you for going on your journey. You will never have the same experience again. So we'll take three big deep breaths to close, filling up. Letting go. Big deep inhale. Sighing it out. And a final deep inhale. Lowering our arms by our sides, and we say, yeah. Blinking the eyes open. Welcome back. Welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me in this breathwork experience. Again, acknowledging you for going on this journey. It is it's quite a wild ride. Would love to hear from you in the comments how that experience was for you, to get a dialogue going with this incredible community of people all over the world. Huge thanks to Abracadabra TV for hosting, for bringing this incredible lineup together. I do encourage you to come back to breathwork whenever you're called. I guide on my Instagram channel at The Chris Keener. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Pacific time. So join me there. Develop your own practice. Your breath is always there for you. And it is my honor and pleasure to remember us of that. Again, my name is Chris Keener. Thanks again. Enjoy the rest of this incredible festival. I know I will be. Put your dancing shoes on, howl at the moon, and drum like your life depends on it.
Welcome to Abracadabra TV.
Live exclusively on Twitch.